تعامل معي المودة والصداقة.
Good afternoon, you're watching the English newscast here on Future Television. I'm Linda Salima. These are today's headlines. Talks in Kazakhstan's capital Astana between key Syria war players end with Russia, Turkey and Iran agreeing on a mechanism to support a delicate ceasefire. The Lebanese army continues its crackdown on suspected militants with alleged ties on a foil suicide attack in Beirut over the weekend. And Lebanese factions meet with senior state officials to push further demands on a new electoral law. Talks between key Syria war players in Kazakhstan's capital Astana have ended with Russia, Turkey and Iran agreeing on a mechanism to support a delicate ceasefire. The meeting, organized by Russia and Turkey and attended by the government and the armed opposition, was aimed at strengthening a nationwide ceasefire that has largely held despite pockets of violence and paving the way towards UN-led political negotiations in Geneva on February 8th. Syrian rebels say they are unhappy with the communique establishing the ceasefire mechanism. An opposition delegate to talks in Astana said the document legitimizes Iran's military offensive, which lead to forcible displacements of thousands of Syrians, causing bloodletting. A second delegate, who said the opposition would not endorse the communique, said Turkey had been weak in the negotiations and unable to assert the rebel position. French Foreign Minister Jean-Marc Ayrault says he is confident a Saudi-funded military aid package for Lebanon will be restored. On a visit to Riyadh, where he is to meet with senior Saudi officials, Ayrault said the package was needed to help bring stability to Lebanon. The $3 billion aid package is to see Riyadh fund the transfer of vehicles, helicopters, drones, cannons and other military equipment from France to the Lebanese army. It is seen as a crucial show of support for Lebanon's military and will provide a boost to French efforts to increase arms sales in the Middle East. Just a reminder that Saudi Arabia halted the program last year in protest at what it said was the stranglehold of Hezbollah on the state in Lebanon. The Lebanese army has continued its crackdown on suspected militants with alleged ties to a foiled suicide attack in Beirut over the weekend. A security source says the army intelligence arrested a suspect in the town of Sinik, south of the southern city of Sidon, raising the number of suspects arrested in the case to more than 10. Police apprehended the suspect, who works as a taxi driver in a car parts shop. He is reportedly a supporter of radical Islamist Sheikh Ahmed Al-Asir. The source added that the detained suspects had already been under surveillance. The Saturday's incident prompted their arrests. Just a reminder, Omar Hassan Asi, a 25-year-old Lebanese national, had entered Costa Coffee in Beirut's Hamra district wearing an 8-kilogram shrapnel-laden explosive belt. Security forces were able to stop him right before he could carry out an attack. Lebanese factions have met with senior state officials to push further demands on a new electoral law. A bloc from MP Walid Jumblat's Democratic Gathering Bloc held talks with Prime Minister Saad Hariri at the Grand Sarai. The delegation, which had previously met with President Michel Aoun and Speaker Nabih Birri, discussed the bloc's conditions for a new vote law with Hariri. Minister Marwan Hamidi said Hariri had been understanding of Jumblat's demands and his bloc's stance wasn't biased or partial. More stories coming up next right after the break. Stay with us. Welcome back. You're watching the English newscast here on Future Television. The Eurozone has started 2017 by maintaining its recent solid growth as a weaker currency boosts orders for goods and services, the survey shows. But rising political risks could take their toll. David Pollard reports.
It's one for the skeptics to mock. Paris's first driverless shuttle bus, a Eurozone with little leadership in a key election year, they might say. But as for the bus itself, it's going along nicely.
The economy seems to be in the right direction. We've seen the stock market do quite well, and the euro is starting to lift as well, but not too much that it chokes off growth.
After a five-year high in December, it was steady as you go in January. A eurozone PMI reading of 54.3, comfortably above the 50 that denotes growth. New orders strong, few signs yet of the clouds a protectionist new US president might cast. And Germany keen to point out silver linings elsewhere.
We must not underestimate what he has in store. We must look for partners that want to work together. When one door closes, and he is closing doors, another opens somewhere else. I'm sure about this.
And for trade, markets keen to see not Trump at the wheel, but his nominee as US Commerce Secretary. Billionaire Wilbur Ross earned his fortune in part by running businesses that offshored thousands of US jobs.
The actual detail will come down to the Commerce Secretary himself. So it's very promising, I think, for the world economy and certainly for global trade that Wilbur Ross doesn't like the idea of protectionism, even though Trump struck a very protectionist note during his inauguration speech.
But companies surveyed also note mounting costs. Input prices in Germany rising at their sharpest pace in 5 years. A surge in inflation likely to be another bump in the road ahead.
And still in Europe, the French capital has inaugurated its first autonomous shuttle bus service as an experiment in what Paris authorities hope will be the future of public transport. The self-driving bus will allow passengers to commute from Paris's Gare de Lyon train station across the River Seine to Austerlitz train station. With only 130 meters on a closed road, the shuttle bus, which can carry up to 10 people at a time, is fully electric and autonomous. Rosanna Philpott reports.
Shuttling their way to a greener city, Paris opening its first driverless buses to the public on Tuesday. Fully electric and fully autonomous, the EZ10 transports up to 10 passengers across the Seine between two main stations. The buses use laser sensors to analyze their surroundings on the road, and for now they don't have to share it with any other vehicles.
The vehicle will adapt to its environment and to pedestrians crossing in front of it, so it'll either slow down or emergency brake if someone jumps in front of it.
José Gómez has been driving buses here for 26 years. He'll oversee the smooth operation of the autonomous bus.
Fewer people come on board. It's slower, it's electric, it doesn't pollute and can be stored away more easily, but it will never replace a traditional bus.
The shuttle comes as Paris faces high pollution levels. City Mayor Anna Hidalgo wants to reduce the number of cars while authorities crack down on traffic restrictions. It may be a short 130 meter stretch for the buses, but for Paris it's a big step towards promoting cleaner transport.
British film Lady Macbeth has been building buzz since it premiered at the Toronto Film Festival and was listed as one of the top 10 films at the festival by trade publication Variety. The film, which follows a young woman forced into a marriage she desperately wants to escape from, was also picked up for distribution by Roadside Attractions. Here's the trailer.
My father bought you, along with a piece of land, not fit enough for a cow to graze upon. You will remain indoors with your prayer book.
I like the fresh air. I like being outside.
Take it off. Your nightdress, take it off. Face the wall. Face the wall!
Where has my husband gone?
Away.
To do what?
Nothing for you to concern yourself with. You'll be on your own for a while.
Must be anticipating the return of your husband.
I must.
It is not good to be without company for too long, I think.
I lost!
I understand you've been taking the air lately. Perhaps a little more time spent indoors will do.
Do you love me?
Of course.
Do you adore me?
Of course.
Through hell and high water, I will follow you.